I like thinking about that sort of stuff, but it would be frustrating if you were forced to believe in that sort of weird stuff. I feel like that's kind of what religion does. It just turns off that rational part of your brain where you're like, oh, man, I was reading this thing. This makes perfect sense. If you just like add these things up. We don't believe in that? Okay, all right. It just, I mean, just on paper here, it really makes a lot of sense. We don't believe in that. Okay, all right. I got to figure out how to live my life knowing that now. All right. And yet they'll force themselves to believe things that you know they don't truly believe in. Or people will be like, did you know that there was a guy who lived in a whale for a few days? Like, you're an adult and you believe that? Yeah, because of my faith. Well, let's never hang out. Let's never hang out. It's ridiculous. I understand at this point, if you're a Christian and you're upset, it's been a lot. But if you are angry, that anger that you feel is exactly proportional to the anger people feel when you're constantly telling them about Christianity. It's exactly the same. Yeah. People know it exists. You don't have to get a bullhorn on your day off and go yell at people on a sidewalk. It's your day off. Do something fun. People know it exists. There's a church in every neighborhood. People are very well aware that it exists. There's a Bible in every hotel room in the world. No one's ever opened up that drawer like, what the? That's a weird. Who did this? This is good. What is this? Who did this? This is good. People know it exists. And I really think that's part of the reason so many people dislike Christianity. Is just because it is so popular. They really don't even know that much about it. It's just like a band that gets way too overplayed on the radio. They're peppered into commercials and television shows. There's a part of you that's just like, all right, enough. You've heard like one song. No, fuck them. You've heard. That's essentially Christianity. If it wasn't so popular, you might really like it because it has so many good things. If it wasn't the most predominant belief, if most people you knew subscribed to a belief that was completely different, say that everyone you knew believed that thousands of years ago, aliens were flying through space with humans in cages as cargo in the back of their ship, and they're running a little low on fuel. It's like, oh God, we're never gonna make it home. We gotta drop these things. There's that little blue planet. Did we get all the lizards off of it? We did? Great. They dropped down, they started unloading the cages, and they're like, all right, remember, we have to separate these things because these little idiots will reproduce like you cannot imagine. So they built some in the Americas, some in Africa, some in Europe, some in Asia, and they're like, all right, let's get out of here. Whoa, wait, how are we going to remember where we put them? Oh, good call, dude. Let's stack up some shit. So they built the pyramids and Stonehenge, City of the Gods. Like, can we see that? We can totally see that. They jumped in their ship and flew home. And then they got carried away doing whatever it is that aliens do for days at a time, which might have been millennia to us. But one day they woke up face down in a pile of cocaine, just like, ah, humans, jumped in their ship and flew back and looked down and went, oh shit. Don't look, do not look. We are fired for sure. Yeah. How many of them did we leave there? 100? I'm not kidding you, there might be a billion. Yeah, there's no saving this. It's been nice working with you. And then they just Thelma and Louise it right into a black hole. I don't know if that's Scientology or what, but imagine if that was the theory that most people you knew subscribed to, and they went to a weird building once a week and wore medallions and drank weird juice and ate things and made weird symbols and went, come back from the black hole, aliens, we believe in you, come back. It would be boring. It would be the most boring thing ever. And Christianity would be the thing that people talk to you about in the back of secondhand bookstores and coffee shops. They'd pull you aside and be like, hey, man, hey, will you believe in that alien nonsense? That's because they want you to, man. They want you to be a sheep, bro. They want you to have blinders on. They want you to be part of the herd. They don't want you to know, okay? They don't want you to know that there's a guy up in the sky. Don't look. You can't see him. There's a guy up in the sky. He built this whole world by himself in 7 days. Oh, no, 7 days. He's wicked smart. And after a while, he got kind of bored. He sent down his son. His son was rad, dude. He's like a carpenter. He built you forts and shit like that. Real mellow, dude. You know what I mean? Mellow. Looked like he'd be in a band or something like that. Just a cool guy. Good guy to have at a party. He could make you sandwiches out of thin air. He could turn water into wine, which is nice. Oh, he could walk on water, too, which is, wait. If he could walk on water and turn it into wine, he wouldn't walk on my wine, would he? Don't walk on my... No, man. No, what? No, he wouldn't walk on your wine? He was a gentleman. That's the whole idea, dude. This guy was super nice. If you lobbed your frisbee across the river, he'd just walk right over and get it for you, dude. Super nice. If you were walking along on the beach and you got a little pooped out, you'd look down, you'd only see one set of footprints, my friend. Because this guy's carrying you. He's carrying you. This guy's nice, homie. That's what I'm getting at. This guy's nice. And that's what they don't want you to know, man. They don't want you to know if you're like him, if you're kind, if you're polite to people for no other reason than to just be nice, you get to go hang out with him and his dad up in the clouds, wear a robe, and not do shit. You'd be like, what? Just be nice and get to do nothing? That's awesome. That's the best idea ever. They should tell you that. They should get bullhorns and yell it at you from the corner. They should put it in a book and put it in every hotel room in the world. They should go house to house and knock on your door and wake you up to tell you about that. No, they shouldn't. That kind of breaks the first rule about being nice. Just keep your beliefs to yourself and let me sleep, you stupid Jehovah's Witnesses. / Mormons, mostly Mormons. Yeah. I think you should be able to believe whatever you want, but maybe just keep them at that. People get too carried away thinking the things they believe are actually things they know. It's like, ah, I better go burn down that clinic. That's how strongly I believe it. Like, why don't you take it easy? If we could all just admit that we don't know anything, we would take a giant step forward and then just kill everyone that doesn't believe that with us. Thanks a lot, you guys. Have a nice evening.
David Huntsberger.